Hey everyone, Jason here. Today I'm excited to show you the first prototype actually for my latest project. Now usually I spend days, weeks, even months finishing up a project and then I make a video of the final model and I show you a little bit how it works. But for this project I wanted to try something a little bit different. That is kind of bring you along for the ride. So over the next few weeks I'll be posting videos of the progress as I go. And that way I can kind of show you how things work as I get them to work, and also maybe give you a little bit of insight into the design process that I typically go through. So I've had this idea in the back of my mind for a while now that I want to build a Mindstorms Lego machine that will itself be able to construct other Lego models. Now I don't know how complex those models will eventually be, but for this initial project I thought I would keep it extremely simple and have it build two-dimensional Lego mosaics using different colored 1x1 plates. But I don't just want it to build pre-programmed mosaics. I want to be able to feed it an image, say this, or pretty much anything, and have it scan that image using the Mindstorms color sensor, and then rebuild that image in Lego mosaic form. So for this initial prototype, I just wanted to test being able to pick up the 1x1 plates, move them around, and then attach them to another plate. So let's take a closer look at how that works. One of the reasons it's actually taken me a while to get around to this project is that I wanted to find a way to pick up and place pieces that didn't require any kind of complex grabbing mechanism. I wanted it to be as simple as possible. And after sorting through some Lego one day, I stumbled upon this guy, which is a pretty common piece. It's used to attach things to the back of a minifig. Like so. Now there's a stud on the back there, you see. And what really caught my eye about this is the part that slides over the minifig's head. It's the diameter of a stud, but it's only about half the thickness of one, which means that the clutch power between it and the stud is strong enough to, let's say, pull a piece up off the table. But when I attach that piece to another piece, the clutch power between the pieces is stronger. So when I pull it off, the piece gets left behind. And this part's actually pretty easily built into some kind of arm, which is what I'm using on the prototype here. And that way it can easily pick up some parts and attach them to another one. With this prototype, I also wanted to test how precisely I could place the pieces. So what I have going on here are two sets of gear racks driven by these Mindstorms motors. And there's one vertical one which moves the part up and down, and then there's a set of horizontal ones which are used to move the part forwards and backwards. And the reason I'm only placing the parts along one dimension is that that's all I really needed to test the precision. I figured there's no sense building an overly elaborate prototype just to find out that it wasn't going to work. So let's see it in action. Right now I have a little test program, and all it does is pick the parts up from the front of the supply and then kind of randomly attaches them to this plate here. So I'm really excited about how well it's worked out so far. I had some real concerns before I started about how precise the motor systems would be and whether or not I would be able to place the 1x1 plates accurately enough, but it all seems to work, which is cool. The next thing I'm going to be working on is some kind of automated feeding system so that I can deliver 1x1 plates in different colors into some kind of supply that the machine can go and pick them out of. Also, now that I know that the gear rack system works for positioning, I've basically got to mount this on another set so that it can move the plates in two dimensions. Hope you enjoyed the video. I'm obviously trying something a little bit different here, so I'd love to hear what you have to think about it in the comments. Thanks for watching, keep on building, and I will see you next week.